Good morning. The topic which we are going to handle today is how NRIs can set up a business in India.
Namaskar dosto, mera naam Gaurav hai. Gauravdelhirav mera YouTube channel hai. Kripya subscribe kare dosto, ye subscribe ka button dabaye, saath mein bell icon ko click karna na bhule.
Currently foreign investment to India is at an all time high. Thus, it is unsurprising that NRIs too want to get into the action. Currently, there are no restrictions either for foreigners or for NRIs to incorporate a business in India. Prior to FEMA, when the Regulatory Act was Foreign Exchange Regulation Act, FERA, NRIs were not allowed to incorporate, subscribe to Indian companies without permission from the RBI. But now they are fully allowed. However, with the repeal of FERA, such restrictions have been abolished. So what kinds of types of entity should an NRI can set up? So we are going to discuss. Currently, foreign investment, partnership, proprietorships and other one-person companies are not allowed in India. So in the case of limited liability partnership, foreign investment is allowed only with a prior approval of the RBI. So however, in the case of private limited company, foreign investment is allowed freely. So we will advise you to go for private limited companies because foreign investment is allowed freely over here. Hence, this is most convenient entity that NRI should look to set up a business in India. So I have told the same. Setting up a business for NRIs, things to know. You must know few things, few do's and few don'ts. So we are going to have a small summarized discussion over the same. So registration. The website of Ministry of Corporate Affairs contains a simplified registration for incorporation of private limited companies for NRIs. Becoming a director. What it takes to be a director. Under the amended Companies Act 2013, an NRI and even a foreign national can become a director of a company incorporated in India. To become a director, one needs a director identification number after obtaining a DSC, digital signature certificate. For these processes to be conducted from overseas, NRIs need to produce copies of passport and address proof and get them attested at their respective Indian embassies abroad, high commissions or consulates abroad. So this is the important point. Now we will talk about DSC and DIN. So a digital signature of the director must be created and registered electronic submission of incorporation form. The digital signatures are certified by agencies provided under the Information Technology Act 2000 and acting as vendors in Indian portals. They are obtained after paying requisite fees and may be renewed from time to time. On production of valid document, DSC can be registered within 24 hours. Now we'll talk about the DIN number. So this is unique number allotted to by the Ministry of Corporate Affairs to a person appointed as a director in a company as NRI. It is obtained by applying under form DIR-3 under section 153 and 154 of the Companies Act 2013. The form is digitally signed and needs to be attested by a company secretary after payment of fees. DIN can be obtained once DSC is approved by the government. So now we are talking about the number of directors. For a private limited, the minimum number of directors is 2 while the maximum is 15. However, this maximum number can be increased if needed by passing a special resolution. Residence of directors. While there is no restriction as to what nationality a director must be, section 149(3) of the Companies Act 2013 required that any one director should be classified as resident of India under the Income Tax Act. So if you are a two director company running as a private limited company, and you must have a one director which must be resident of India. So you need a person who is resident in India. Registered office. One main requirement of incorporation of a company is that it must have a registered office in India. For a company to be registered in India by the Ministry of Corporate Affairs, it should have a registered office in India itself. So you need to have a registered office. It can be a residence office or a residence area of the director which is living in India. So you can choose the same. Another one is SPICE method. This is an incorporation method, so we are not going to discuss the same. So what are the important other points needed to be obtained to become a director as an NRI in private limited company? In order to establish itself as a separate legal entity, a company will require a permanent account number, which is known as PAN, and tax deduction and collection account number, that is 10. Form 49A, 49B of the Income Tax Department needs to be filed with for the same. Now, what other details are required? Notifying RBI. So if we will talk about the same. Notifying RBI. Depending on the sector in which the company is the function, RBI notification may or may not be necessary in the case of business in a sector that allows 100% FDI under the automatic route. RBI notification is not required if you are running into a 100% FDI automatic route. If the specification of 100% is not specified, then RBI will be required to inform prior to your incorporation and becoming a director on the same. So, shareholders. Shareholding in an Indian company may be by foreign or foreign national depending on the FDI norms in the particular sector. The Reserve Bank of India allow 100% FDI in many sectors, and such sectors have completely foreign shareholding as well. Thus, setting up a business in India is no longer complicated matter. In fact, foreigners and NRI are engaged to establish their business in India through the amended Companies Act and many online initiatives that have been launched. So guys, please, if you are an NRI, then you can start your entity in India. So if you are thinking that you will start your business later on after 2 or 3 years when you will come back to India, that won't be a good idea. You can establish your entity with an Indian director, which must be a resident of India, and you must be an NRI. You can also become director in the same, and there is no tax problem for the same for you. So you can start your company, you can start your business. So this way you can start as an NRI in an Indian base, and you can invest in India as well. So I appreciate if you help the economy in growing up as an NRI director. Please subscribe the channel and hit the bell button.